Why is methylfolate the off switch for the glycine buffer system?
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. Jeff Huseby says, why is methylfolate the off switch for the glycine buffer system? If methylfolate is providing more methyl groups, shouldn't there be a greater need to buffer them, or at least potentially shouldn't it turn the system on instead of off? No. So the reason is that generally in the fed state, you have lots of incoming methionine. And so you have an excess of SAMe in the fed state. In the fasting state, you have no incoming methyl groups from diet. And therefore, the fasted state is the low methylation state. So fed state, high methylation state, fasted state, low methylation state. You basically shut off MTHFR in the fed state. Because in the fed state, which is a high methylation state, the incoming methionine makes you not need any MTHFR activity. In the fasted state, so you know, you don't need methylfolate in the fed state because you just have this constant flux of methionine in from the steak that you ate. So in the fasting state, MTHFR gets switched on by the low level of SAMe. And then that methylfolate is a symbol of the low methylation fasted state. So the low methylation fasted state is symbolized by methylfolate, which then shuts off the glycine buffer system, because you want to shut off the glycine buffer system in the low methylation fasted state, and you want it to be on in the high methylation fed state. Hope that helps, Jeff. Thank you for your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ Master Pass, where I hold monthly private Zoom Q&As for my members. The Master Pass also serves as a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. If you'd like to participate in these Q&As, you can join the Master Pass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for 10% lifetime discount. I am currently working full-time on finishing my first book, Vitamins and Minerals 101, How to Get the Nutrients You Need on Any Diet. I will let you know when I have a release date. In the meantime, you can pre-order the book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. Testing Nutritional Status, the ultimate cheat sheet, has been newly released as version 1.3. This is my comprehensive system for managing nutritional status with lab tests, dietary analysis, and comprehensive intake of your signs and symptoms. The new version has a comprehensive guide to interpreting the Genova methylation panel. You can pick up your copy at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. Please consider supporting my work at no extra cost to you by visiting my support page and making a purchase with one of my affiliate links. Some of my most popular affiliates are also listed in the description of this video with links that will give me credit for your purchase. I will try to respond to comments when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.